If you look at the lower part of this of your screen, you see on the right where you see those. Okay. I want you to be able to raise your hand. Look at the right side down. You see, raise your hand. So you can raise your hand, or you can send a question to me in the chat. Today we are just there to just talk about questions and answers and anything that is bothering concerns, just anything general. Today is not a major class. Today is just like a follow-up class. And then if there are any issues that we need to talk about, I'm going to be doing that here. Yes, David Bello, you're welcome. Thank you, everyone. So no more chatting. Everyone just pay attention. I understood everything, no questions. Anybody else, we can't, even with good, we're going to have to close the class early. If you have any questions, anything that you know I did not talk about, you want to ask about it, please do that. While that is going on, there's something I want to talk about. I want to tell you guys about. That thing is about touching our body. That thing is about touching our body. So we are at a stage of our life where, because of all the things that are happening, you know, with you and your body, sometimes some boys and some girls start touching themselves. Okay, someone has a question about menstruation. Okay, no problem. I'll come to your question. Please don't jot it down. I'm going to jot it down myself. Someone has a question, about menstruation. If you have any question, please just go to the chat room and just type it while I continue. So, what you need to know is that okay, so sorry about that. So some boys and some girls, they start touching themselves. Just, you know, they are doing it like a habit. For example, the boys, they just put their hand in their face, just touching it, just touching it, just touching it. It's not good. Nobody's supposed to touch your body, even you. You are. Oh, is there anybody here that cannot have their bath by themselves? Please. You know that your mommy and daddy is still bathing you. Can I see? Can you raise your hand? Let me go through my video now. You know that your mommy or your daddy is still bathing you. I don't think anybody here is still being bathed by their mommy or their daddy. Everybody here is old enough to bathe by themselves. So nobody, your friends are not supposed to touch you. You're not supposed to touch yourself. You're not supposed to touch any part of your body. Girls, you are not supposed to touch your breast. Boys, you're not supposed to touch your penis. You're not supposed to put your hand in your vagina. You're not supposed to touch no part of your body. For the boys, after this class, when you go to school, maybe whenever school resumes, or for those of us that are going to boarding house, when you go to boarding house, they start telling you as a boy, that, yes, you know, you can touch your penis. That you look like a real man, you know, you can touch it so that it will grow bigger. Those things are lies. Don't let anybody like you. And don't let anybody touch your own. Don't touch anybody's own. Are you listening to me, everyone? Don't touch your body part. Don't let anybody touch you. And don't touch anybody. I'm so sorry. My network, loved me, but I thank God that everyone is still here. So I was saying about the three rules of touch. The first is don't touch yourself. Second is don't touch anyone. Third is don't let anyone touch you for any reason they do. Okay? The body is private and you should. The only time you should touch yourself is when you are bathing. Wash your body, clean your body properly, and leave the bathroom. Please do not take a phone into the toilet. Do not take a gadget into your toilet. Do not allow people to say that, oh, when you go into the bathroom, snap yourself. Just snap it on your mommy's phone. Don't do that. Phones are not for snapping naked pictures. Please. Your phone is for snapping beautiful pictures and beautiful sights. Do not use it to snap yourself. Whether, when you're doing a selfie, your selfie is supposed to show yourself from head to toe. Don't come and snap only from here up. Just snap, put your dress, you snap it. You put your lower part, you snap it. No, that is not what pictures and cameras are for. Your body is private. Every part of your body is private. Nobody else should see it. Do you know what is happening now? Some people tell their friends to snap pictures of themselves when they are not wearing their clothes. And they send it to them. And those ones will now start sharing it to all their other friends. So before you know what is happening, you are living in Abuja, but your naked picture has reached Australia, Canada, London. It has gone around the world. Because the internet is a very fast plane. The internet is like a rocket. Your picture will just be going all around. And some people even tell people to pay before they give them back their picture. Some people even take it to a fair. Then everybody will now be laughing at them. But how did it start? It started from you taking a picture of yourself. Do not take a picture of yourself and show to anybody. Do not take it and show to yourself. If anybody comes to you and says, yes, somebody said, my mommy said they can use it to blackmail. That's true. Now I'm telling you what your mommy said is true. They can use it and say, if you don't be my girlfriend, I'll show everybody this picture. That's blackmail. They can use it and say, if you don't be my girlfriend, I'll show everybody this picture. I'm going to send this picture to the principal. I'm going to collect your iPhone from you. If you don't give me that your iPhone, I'm going to show everybody your picture. I'm going to put it on Facebook. That's blackmail. They'll be threatening you. But it was your fault because you snapped that picture in the first place. Don't let your siblings do it. Some siblings do it. They say, okay, let's come out of the bathroom. Yeah, they'll now snap. Some of them will go in front of a mirror and now be snapping themselves with their towel or with just their, small clothes on their body. It is not good. Do not do it. Okay? Now, another thing that we should be very careful about is how we take care of our body. Some of us here, like the boys, you have to be very careful because you start having body odor. Then you now say that, everybody, nobody likes me. Nobody wants to be my friend. Nobody's playing with me. It's just because your body is smelling. And people don't like staying near people that smell. Sorry, excuse me. You have to be very, very careful. You have to be very careful. Wash your body. Let me tell you how to wash your body. Let me tell you how to have your bath. When you want to have your bath, you get a bucket of water, or if your shower is running, you get it set, you get your soap. I'm going to ask you this question. get your soap, you get your sponge, you get your clean water. You first pour water on yourself. You have that money, your bathroom, that if I call your mommy, she will not tell you that you are smelling. She will not tell me that you are smelling. You get soap and water, you wash, you put the soap in the sponge. After pouring water on yourself, you start scrubbing. When you're scrubbing all part of your body, make sure you scrub your armpit very well. Make sure that you scrub in between your thighs, that's like where your laps are. Any place that there is fat, scrub that place well. Put your hand, scrub it. That's the only time you're allowed to touch, and that's because you're not touching, you're just having your bath. Scrub properly, then now rinse your body. Don't pour water on yourself if you have not put soap and water. Make sure that you wash your undies. Wash your pants, wash your boxers, okay? Wash a bit. I hope mommy and dad is not washing anybody's clothes in this class. I hope mom and dad are not washing anybody. If your mommy is still washing your pants, I'm going to laugh at you now. Let me start laughing. That's still washing your pants and your boxers. You can do it. It's not difficult. You can do it. Just put your soap and water in the bucket and just use your water and just scrub, especially the part that touches your private part. Just wash it. Just it like this. Put it in plenty of energy. Stop piling your pants. Some of you, if I come to your room in the spirit now, should I come into your room now? I will see something that will pursue me from your room or your bathroom because you have been keeping your pants since last week. Your pants are there. Some people, their boxers, they are there since July 1st. Today is July 17th. They are just filing. If you don't know how to start taking care of yourself now, when you become a full teenager, you start having body odor. And then people will not want to be your friends. Then the few people that want to be your friends will now come and be saying, if you don't smoke, we'll not be your friend. You'll now say, please, I want to be your friend. You will not do everything they say. That is what starts peer pressure. Because you're not confident, and you cannot be confident in yourself if you are not clean. Cleanliness is next to godliness. If you are not clean, God cannot stay with you and near you. So you have to be very clean and tidy. Everybody in this class is supposed to be able to wash their toilet and their bathroom. Wash, use a toilet cleaner. You might not be able to do it very well, but try. Don't just, that is how to take care of your body as a teenager, because you're going through puberty. Someone said that anytime my brother comes back from playing football, he's always smelly. Yes, because of sweat. And then some of you, your hair, I can place my attachment inside your hair. This one I can place. This one I can place. I can fix this one. Because you are not shaving, you tell your mommy and daddy to help you with the shaving stick and shave it. It's very important. Number three thing that you need to do now that you're going through puberty: do not allow your friends to spoil you. If your friend sends you a message that is not good, tell your friend, don't send me that message again, or else I'm going to block you, or else I'm going to delete you. Are you listening to me? Some of your friends are going to have phones before you. You will now say they will be telling you things. Any picture or any video that somebody sends to you that is naked body, that is showing naked people, don't watch it. You know why? Because if you start watching it, you cannot stop. You become addicted. Addicted is when you are doing something that you know is bad, but you are still doing it. So the best thing for you is that don't even start it. Anybody that comes to tell you, and you know, you will know when somebody wants to show you something that is wrong, because the person will be hiding. If you have any friend like that looks like this friend likes this kind of thing, cutting yourself off from that person. Friendship is not by force. Friendship is by choice. Friendship is by you choose your, you're the one that will choose your friend. You're the one that will say, this person is my friend. This person is my friend. But this one, this person is not my friend at all. My ears will not hear about negative. I will not go to this side. And let me tell you, if you're listening to me here, none of you here in this class to go to the internet without a trusted adult. This is number four. I've listed 3 points. This is the fourth one. Do not go to the internet. What I mean is, do not go to WhatsApp, do not go to YouTube, do not go to Facebook, do not go to Instagram, all those things. Or you say you want to just go. Mommy, I want to go Google. How is trusted? After this class, you are going to send me the four things I've said. Please, under this number four, tell me who the trusted adults are. Go and ask your mommy. Say, mommy, who are the trusted adults that can help me anytime I want to go to the internet? I must not go to the internet alone. Say, mommy, Auntie Etima said, Auntie Etima is the one that said, my mentor said that I cannot go to the internet by myself. Some of you are doing online classes. Your parents will help you. Your parents will help you. They'll set up your Microsoft team or they'll set up your Zoom class that some of you, your parents have done and they're close by. That is how it should be. Do not go and start joining groups. You just say, hey, all the girls in the class, they're in one group. The name of the group is Silly Girls Group. Huh? They send you the link, you just click, you join. The name of this group is Baba International Boys Group. Come, you join. Do not do that. Don't go to the internet. Don't go to Google. Some young children are going to the internet and they're just asking anything. And you know Google is very funny. Anything you ask on Google will tell you. But many of the things that Google are telling you are lies. They are lies. Some of them, not all. And Google will tell you what Google wants to hear. So for example, Google likes boy and boy to marry, girl and girl to marry. Because that's what people are putting. All these Americans are saying that it's okay for boy and boy to marry. It's okay for girl and girl to marry. So if you go and press it on Google, Google will tell you, yes, it's good. So that is why you should not go to the internet without a trusted adult. So you're going to list for me on the group. What are a trusted adult? Be your daddy, be your uncle, you know those people. But if you have anybody that is always trying to do something wrong to you, that person is not a trusted adult. Okay, do you understand me? So, be very, very careful about the internet. Your mommy's phone. It's not correct. That is not good. Difficult for you out of that place. So please, everyone that is listening to me, do not go to the internet. You're not, hope nobody is on Facebook. You're not supposed to be on Facebook yet. You're not yet 13. Some of you should not even go to the internet until you're like 16. Until you are ready, until you can say no and mean it. Don't go there. Don't let your neighbors come and, you know, some of you, now this is number six. When you go to your friend's house, when you go to your cousin's house, don't let them put any video or movie that is not good. If the movie says, rated 13. Nobody in this class is 13. Don't watch it. Those of you that are on Nickelodeon, you watch the Nickelodeon program and they will say, they said 15, and you are watching it, you are doing something wrong. If you're 10 years, watch only the program that says 10 or below. 6, 7, 8. Those are new types you should watch. When you're in your house, you obey. When you now go to your cousin's house, that's all, I'm not here. My mom is not here. You don't need that here. It's wrong. Tell them, I will not watch this thing because it's not my age. And even when it is your age, when they start, when you just notice that everything about this thing is just kissing, touching, opening body, just looking back to it. Tell them that I'm not watching again. I'm not learning anything from this thing. I'm sorry. Can you change it or you switch it off? And let's talk about some other things. Don't go and follow your cousin. Lock the door. Lock the door. Mm. Let's see what will happen. You will not be doing like that. Then when somebody's coming, when your auntie, your uncle is coming, or somebody's coming, you will not change it. And start watching your church program. Hey, look at what my bishop is saying. But you know that that's not what you're watching before. You will not be hiding. You know that God is seeing you. God has big, mighty eyes that is watching you when nobody's watching you. So you have to be very, very careful. And the reason why you should not watch all these things is because when you close your eyes to sleep, or you close your eyes to read, all those things that you have been watching will start coming out again. Is it okay to watch a movie rated 13 when you are 12? You are 12, you're not yet 13. When you are 13, start watching it. Please, everybody, okay? Just watch only what is your race. Don't be in a hurry. You will watch, and do you know why I'm saying so? Because if you're 12 and you're watching rated 13, when you get to 13, you start watching rated 16. When you are 15, you start watching rated 18. When you always be doing things that are older than you. You need to start doing things that are for your age. Don't be your 10-year-old. All your friends are 15 years old. Only you don't go and say that mate. That's what they're saying. Go and stay with your mate. Don't go and be saying where you'll be hearing things that senior people are talking about. When you hear your mom and your dad, they are talking about, talking to each other. Go away from there. Don't sit down and be listening. Or your mommy and her friends are talking. I know the way mommies and their friends are talking. Everything. You see what happened to that man, that woman. Hey, you see what happened on social media. You're not listening. You go and put your ear and be hearing. It happened to me when I was small, when I was younger. But nobody taught me. I have senior cousins that were living in our house. I would go and peep in the window and be watching what they are doing. I would be listening to what they are saying. When I entered secondary school, I struggled. When my teacher is speaking, I'll be remembering all those things that I was watching when I was 7 years, 8 years, 9 years, 10 years, like you, some of you. I will now be, those things will now be, and playing in my mind. So that's why I'm telling you, be careful what you watch, because what you watch, your brain is like a camera. When you just snap, if you go to gallery, you see. So there's a gallery in your mind. If you go to your mind now, you see all the bad pictures and videos that you have been watching. Even if you have deleted them from where you watch them, it's still inside your mind. Your mind has a gallery. So you need to be careful. Somebody asked a question and said, what if your cousins will not agree? Then you stand up from there and leave. Stand up from the neighbor's house and leave. Is there any place you go to that they tie your leg? Is there any place that when you go there, they just tie your leg, tie your hands, open your eye like this? You use needle, you open your eye like this. Is there any place that they force you to stay there? No. So leave that place and say, Mom, I will not be going to this house again because of this. They keep showing pictures and videos that are not good for my gallery. Tell your mommy like that. They keep showing pictures and videos. I will not watch it, Mom, and I will not go to the house again. Because some of them now, they are old. Some of the people that have been watching, they are old and they have problems. Some of them cannot cope in school. They are going to expel them from their school. Some of them cannot pass in school. They are having problems, having carryover. You know what is carryover? Carryover is when you fail a course and you have to repeat that course. So your mates will be going ahead, you will be staying back. And the reason you are failing is not because you're not intelligent or smart. It's just because of all the things that are in your gallery. All the pictures, all the videos, when your parents are sleeping, your mom is in the parlor with you. People are watching channels or AIT. Your mommy will now sleep. You now take the remote. You go and change. Because nobody's watching you. You now begin. You're just snapping pictures of yourself and sitting in your gallery. When they come and ask you, what is the algebra? Mention the types of the members of the family. You start forgetting things. You need to be very, very careful. Okay, so I'm done for today. Any question? Does anybody have any question you want to ask? If it's your elder brother or your elder sister, tell them what you are watching is bad. Go and tell your mom or dad. Tell a trusted adult that this, my elder sister, this situation is not right. I don't want to do that. I don't want to put something in my gallery that will not help. Report. Yes, that means to say, all the sharp mouth, all the people, cannot keep your mouth. And then tell someone, tell your mom, tell your dad. Let them know like you, let them know. After some time, you start liking you again. Because you're doing it for yourself. You're doing it to help yourself. So it's changing. Any questions before we go? Does anybody understand? So don't show your naked body to anybody in form of a picture. Don't snap your naked body, no matter the part of your body. Don't take a phone, a laptop, iPhone, iPad, all those things. Don't take to the bathroom. Anybody, anybody, warn that friend, block that friend, avoid that friend. That is what I've been saying. When you have anything that is happening to you that you can't understand, talk to your mom about it. Don't keep secrets. Don't hide and watch bad things. It will not leave your mom. Okay, so we don't have any questions. I'm going to have to call it a day. I'm going to put on everybody's mic. So that everybody can say their goodbye. Everybody, please unmute your mic so that we can all say goodbye.
Bye.